my head went quiet. All the ticks, all the constantly refreshing images just disappeared. When you have obsessive compulsive disorder, you don't really get quiet moments. Even in bed, I'm thinking, did I lock the doors? Yes. Did I wash my hands? Yes. Did I lock the doors? Yes. Did I wash my hands? Yes. But when I saw her, the only thing I could think about was the hairpin curve of her lips, or the eyelash on her cheek, that eyelash on her cheek, that eyelash on her cheek, and I knew had to talk to her. I asked her 6 times in 30 seconds. Love and mental illness are two very important facets of life, but we tend to ignore what happens when they clash in the center. The burden of mental illness mixed with the ups and downs of modern relationships are explored in OCD and Me But Happy by Neil Hilborn. She said yes after the third one, but none of them felt right, so I had to keep asking. On our first date, I spent more time organizing my meal by color than I did eating it or talking to her, but she loved it. She loved that I had to kiss her goodbye 16 times, or 24 times if it was Wednesday. She loved that it took me forever to walk home because there are lots of cracks in our sidewalk. When we moved in together, she said she felt safe. Like no one would ever try to rob us because I had definitely locked the door 18 times. I'd always watch her mouth when she talked, when she talked, when she talked, when she talked, when she said she loved me. Her mouth would curl up at the edges. At night, she'd lay in bed and watch me turn the lights on and off and 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 on and off. She'd close her eyes and imagine the days and nights passing in front of her. Some mornings, I'd start kissing her goodbye, and she'd just leave. Because I was making her late for work. When I stopped in front of a crack in the sidewalk, she just kept walking. When she said she loved me, her mouth was a straight line. She told me I was taking up too much of her time. Last week, she started sleeping at her mother's place. She told me that she shouldn't have let me get so attached to her, that this whole thing was a mistake. But how can it be a mistake when I don't have to wash my hands after I touch her? Love is not a mistake, and it's killing me that she can run away from this, and I just can't. I can't. I can't go out and find someone new because I always think of her. Usually, When I obsess over things, I see germs sneaking into my skin. I see myself crushed by an endless succession of cars, and she was the first beautiful thing I ever got stuck on. I want to wake up every morning thinking about the way she holds her steering wheel. How she turns shower knobs like she's opening a safe. How she blows out candles, 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 blows out. Now I just think about who else is kissing her. I can't breathe because he only kisses her once. He doesn't care if it's perfect. I want her back so bad. I leave the door unlocked. I leave the lights on. I would like to thank you personally for always making me feel like I'm the king of the Pope of the whole world. When I'm around you, it's like I'm full of electricity, but in a cool way. The best part about being in love with you is I never have to brush my teeth, but gosh darn do I want to. You're the best thing that's happened to me since I was, like, born. You make me want to do pointless, actually dumb things, like learning to play the flute or voting. Oh my god, I'm just kidding. You have to freaking vote. In a list of things I love about you, maybe the second or third entry is the way you turn my awful days into awful days with cheeseburgers. Have you ever smashed your face into a whole bunch of cool, wet sand? Well, you should, because that's pretty much what it's like to hang out with you. I've never made out with Jesus, but I imagine that's kind of like holding your hand. If I had rickets, it'd be okay, because I have rickets with you. I would like to thank you for never, not once, not ever making fun of me for crying while I watched the same scene from Parks and Recreation for the 25th time. I want to thank you for letting me fall in love with you and then deciding to start a pop punk band. I want to thank you for listening to all of the mixes I've made you. Or at least pretending to sort of like them. I always try to be like cool and stuff, but it's hard to act like I don't care when you're so pretty all the goddamn time. The new way to say I love you is to just ram our foreheads together. We can't really be sad if we're both sad in the same place, right? I want to thank you for wanting me to be me, but happy. I don't know why we're both here, but since we are, let's make out till we're dead. Before I met you, I wanted to be dead all the time. I still do because of the, you know, mental illness. But now that you're here, I don't want to die anymore. If you were a breakfast cereal, you'd be called Reason to Wake Up O's, and sure, There are probably infinite dimensions. But I'm with you in this one. So why would I try to find them?